You see that live on YouTube now, Guruji?
My pranams to all Atma Jyotis, Divine Light of Self. I welcome all of you for today's session of contemplation based on Sri Ramana Maharshi's teachings. We are taking up Vichara Sara Sangraha. So the disciple is asking Ramana Maharshi how to know that in the heart, the self itself shines as Brahman. In the heart, self itself shines as Brahman. Okay. The self is the Atma. Brahman is, Atma is the myself. It is not individual self. It is the impersonal self of me. So this self is Brahman. Brahman means all pervading reality. How do you know that? Is the question. Self is at the individual level, Vyashti. And Brahman is Samashti, all pervading. So the Vyashti and Samashti difference is, Vyashti is a, Vyashti means is a tree. One tree is Vyashti. Forest is Samashti. Self or Atman is referring to the Vyashti, individual. The Brahman is referring to Samashti, the totality. Right? The Brahman is Samashti or God. Vyashti is individual self. Atman. So Atman is, Atman shines as Brahman in the heart. How is it possible? Is the question. How do you know that? How do you say that? Is the question clear? Because self, when we think of self, we think of an individual, limited individual. Limited to the body and mind. And Samashti we are thinking of is a totality, vast, infinite. God. The self, the essence of the totality is Brahman. The essence of individual is Atman. How do we know Atman shines as Brahman in the heart? The heart is the word heart is not a physical heart, it's a spiritual center. Spiritual heart, as I told earlier. Okay. Bhagavan answers. So in a lamp, okay, the lamp is in one place. The lamp spreads the radiation all around. The radiation goes all around. The lamp radiation spreads all around, fills the whole room. In the radiation, there is no difference. It fills everywhere. It fills, that radiation is there within the lamp, within the flame of the lamp, and outside the flame of the lamp. The same radiation is there. So also, the self, Atman, the light of the self, Atma Jyoti, fills without any difference within and without, within me and without me. It is inside and outside. The radiation of the light of the self fills everywhere. Light of the self is like, he has gives an example of lamp. The lamp is in one place. The radiation comes all around. The radiation is there in the lamp, in the flame, as well as outside. Similarly, self, the radiation of the self, Atma, is in the form of Atma Jyoti. The Atma Jyoti spreads everywhere. He gives the example of a lamp and the lamp to tell us what heart is all about. Heart is the spiritual center, heart. That's called heart. It is not a physical heart. Physical heart is a blood pumping mechanism. He is speaking of a spiritual center called Hradayam, Hradi Ayam, where I am there, the real feeling of I exist is there, is called Hradayam. Hradayam, the physical heart is in the body, is in the time and space. Hradayam is not in time and space, it's beyond time and space. It's awareness, it's the light of awareness, which is beyond time and space. So the Hradayam, your physical heart, also called Hradayam, but it exists in the body. But the spiritual heart, Hradayam, is beyond the body, it's beyond time and space. In the spiritual heart, Hradayam, the self is there, and the radiation from the self spreads everywhere. Okay, that everywhere is called Brahman, all pervading. And in that spiritual heart, spiritual center, or Hradayam, the body is there, mind is there, world is there. In the Atma Jyoti, body and mind and world are there. This is the teaching of Sri Ramana Maharshi. So this disciple asked the follow-up question, next question. So is this answer to the question clear? The answer is not clear. What is not clear?
So, something that I'm trying to imagine.
No. It's not imagination, no. When you see the world. Correct, I'm saying. See, his question is, there is the two Atman and Brahman we are speaking of. Atman is the self.
It's like
with respect to individual, Vesti. Brahman is to totality. Now, Atman or self is in the heart, Hradayam, the spiritual heart center. Okay. So the Brahman is all pervading. So there's now two things we are speaking of. One is being at the center and being all pervading. They are two opposite, the conflicting things. The lamp is in one place, but the radiation from the lamp is spreading everywhere. Right? Lamp is in one place. So the heart is said to be in the heart. The Atman is said to be the spiritual heart, spiritual center, heart, Hradayam. Now if it is Hradayam, how is it related to all pervading reality, Brahman? So Ramana Maharshi gives the example of a flame. The flame of a lamp is in one place, but the radiation from the flame of lamp is all around.
Spiritual heart is
the spiritual center or heart is beyond time and space. But the radiation from that is the light of the self, Atma Jyoti. Atma Jyoti spreads everywhere. That's Brahman.
So spiritual heart is universal, not individual.
Mm-hmm.
My spiritual.
Spiritual heart is not individual, it's universal. So spiritual heart is, it's called self. But the self, from the self, the radiation from the self called awareness spreads throughout. Atma Jyoti. That's Brahman. All pervading reality. Right? So the question is, can you be in one center and all pervading? Also, it's like a self always gives a feeling that it's in one place. Brahman means it gives a feeling that it's all pervading. So all pervading in one, being in one place, how they can be together? That's what is the question. Is the question answer clear? So the next question comes. Next question. So this answer is clear, right? Self is in the heart. Then how is it related to Brahman, which is all pervading? So the Ramana Maharshi gives a, you can be in one place, but you can be pervading in a radiation, like lamp. He gives the example of a lamp. So the self is the Atma, okay? And Jyoti from the Atma, awareness, spreads throughout. Can you see the whole world? You are seeing the sky, the sun, the moon, everything you are seeing, the light of awareness. The awareness has spread all around. Brahman. It's not imagination, it's your own experience. Entire world you are seeing in your awareness. And where is the awareness come from? Awareness has come from the self.
What do you mean?
The radiation from the self in the form of awareness, Atma Jyoti, is spreading everywhere.
I am the awareness.
Correct, you are the awareness.
Everything is, again, in form of awareness of the right, you say existence of
correct. There are two aware, the all pervading reality called Brahman is God. Now we are speaking of the Atman, myself, self. It's not myself, self.
Atman individual.
No, no, self. Self is always with respect to me, no? When I speak of self, it's my respect to me. Now this
me
self.
Is not this body.
No, me is not this body. It's not the individual, right? Atman always says with respect to myself, the self, the real self. The real self is not individual, it's universal. The radiation from the universal self spreads and pervades the entire universe in the form of Atma Jyoti, the awareness. So when you open your eyes, the light goes out and falls on the world. That's awareness. If you have to see the sun, your eyes have to open up and your awareness has to go and light up the sun. What do you mean by that?
Okay. Two different words here, self and awareness.
No, self is awareness. Lamp is light. See, the question is one location versus all locations. How is it possible? Is the question. The self or Atman is beyond time and space.
When it is beyond space, obviously there is no point of location.
There's no point of location. So, but the radiation from that manifests as the world of time and space and pervades.
Awareness.
Yeah. Yes, but then he is asking the equation from Atman and Brahman, how they are one and the same.
Because I'm the
awareness,
that's why it is one and the same.
Okay, you already gone ahead of our teaching, okay? Let's go further.
No, not getting.
What is not getting?
You always say, told, I am awareness and everything exists in that awareness, comes and goes.
Correct.
And whatever comes and goes is starting from thoughts, I am, Chitabhasa, everything else is illusion, it comes and goes.
Correct.
I am that awareness which is unchanging beyond time and space.
Correct.
That's all I know. I'm not getting what you're telling this.
But the awareness is beyond time and space. And everything in the time and space, beyond time and space, is called transcendent reality. It is beyond senses. Awareness is beyond senses, is the transcendent reality. Now, what is in the domain of senses? Okay, it's immanent reality, the physical world, the sun, the moon, the earth. So that awareness, the light of the self-awareness falls on that and illuminates those objects. That's all he's saying. That's all he says. That's where his Brahman is coming into picture. Okay. So the next question is, in Brahman is the reality, the self is the reality. Self is the only reality. Okay. The three states of experience, waking, dreaming, deep sleep state, which are not real. How they are appearing in Brahman? How they are appearing in this light of the self, Atma Jyoti, which is one, impartial and self-luminous, which is light of self, there's no duality. It's only one. Light of self is only one. It is self-luminous. Even if they appear, they appear, of course, obviously we know that we are appearing, body is appearing, the world is appearing. How do we know that self alone is there, which is unmoving and unchanging, is the next question. For which Ramana Maharshi gives the illustration, beautiful illustration. I'll show the picture of illustration on the screen. You have to enable the... Bhagavan Ramana Maharshi gives an illustration of Bhagavan gives it. He gives the illustration of a room. Can you see the room? Okay. He gives the illustration of a room. The room has, there are two rooms, illustration of a house. There are two rooms. One is the inner room and other is a outer room. Okay. In the inner room, there's a flame, there's a light. This is the inner room. My movement is there. Okay. So you can see in the inner room, there's a flame that's given by number one. Right? Can you see that flame?
Yeah.
Which is number one. Okay. The number one is called the self, Atman. Number one is the self. Now, don't be under the impression that self is in a room, Atma. It is beyond time and space. But for the purpose of teaching, you are referring to the self in being in a room for the purpose of communication. So the self is beyond time and space, and the self is the heart, the spiritual center. Okay. So it is in the room, first room, which is the inner room. There's an outer room. The inner room is called, inner room has a door. There's a door there, right? You can see the door. The door is number two. This is the door. Number two is the door. Okay. What is the inner room door doing? Inner room door is called sleep. When you go to the bedroom, you close the door. Okay. When you open the door, you wake up in the morning and open the door. So the analogy of the door is given for the sleep. The sleep is the door. Okay. Are you clear? In the sleep, when the door is closed, there's no light of the self going outwards. Please understand, these are all only analogies. Don't make it very, don't take it. All the door is also imagination or mithya. The room is also mithya. All the things are speaking of mithya, unreal. It's like a dream only we are speaking of in the, from the dream reality. But because we are in the dream, we have to understand from the dream point of view. So the sleep is the door number two. Okay. When this door is open, there's a mesh. You can call it number three, Mahatattva. Mahatattva is a mesh. Mahatattva is the universal intelligence. Okay. Universal intelligence is where there's ideas of the universe, the creation, all there in the form. There's like a blueprint of the creation of the universe is there in the universal intelligence. Universe has not come up. It's in the idea form. The jiva, the universe, everything is in the idea form. That universal intelligence is there called Mahatattva. It's not individual, it's Mahatattva, universal. Okay. The door called door of the sleep, number two, opens and closes. How does it open and close? When you go to sleep and when you go to open? How do you wake up? Why do you wake up? There's a doorkeeper. The doorkeeper is not shown here. The doorkeeper is called Prana. Prana Shakti. Prana Shakti is the servant of Atma. Right? That Prana Shakti is servant of Atma. So the Prana Shakti is shown as servant of Rama in the form of Hanuman. Hanuman is the Vayuputra. So Rama is the Atma. Pranashakti, Hanuman is the servant of Rama. Like that, Pranashakti is servant of Atma. The Atma is the one who opens the door. When you wake up from the sleep, it's not you waking up from the sleep. The Pranashakti has to open the door of sleep for you. Otherwise, you will not wake up. What is the guarantee that you will go to sleep and when you wake up? It's not a conscious activity. Waking up from the sleep is not a conscious activity. The prana has to open the gate of sleep. You have to wake you up. Similarly, going to sleep also is not a conscious activity. You want to, you may go on sleep on the bed, but then you fall into sleep when the Pranashakti has moved, when the Pranashakti has closed the door. Is the analogy clear? The sleep and waking up is because of the Pranashakti, vital force of the body.
What happens to Pranashakti when
it will continue. It will continue in the heart, physical heart. Okay. Now the Pranashakti opens and closes the door based on your karmic impressions, karma vasana. So your all karmas are over, let's say today. You have no karmic impressions left. Then you don't wake up from the sleep. The door will be closed permanently. So we wake up from the sleep to experience the prarabdha karma. The gate for opening the Pranashakti is because of prarabdha karma. Do you understand? Prarabdha karma is the trigger. The gatekeeper will open the door based on your prarabdha karma. You have to experience more, you have to go out. Okay. And when you go out, the door is opened. Immediately, the light will fall on the Mahat Tattva, which is the universal intelligence, where the whole idea of the universe is in very subtle form. The door number four, okay, is the causal body. The body which you are there in sleep is called causal body. I mean, you still feel you are individual in sleep. No, that's why you say, I fell asleep. You don't feel that you are merged with the universe. I am asleep, you literally say. Your ignorance is there still. You don't know that you are one with the Brahman. So the causal body, whatever body you think you are there in the deep sleep, is called causal body. So that is number four, is the inner room. Right? And please understand, all these are mithya or unreal, imaginary only. For the purpose of explaining, we are telling.
So the self is inside the causal body.
Self is inside the causal body. So that's why Mandukya Upanishad says, I am Atma Brahma. You touch your chest and say, I am Atma Brahma. This self is Brahman. So there he is referring to this self is the self you are in the sleeping state. In the sleeping condition, you are enjoying blissfully. The Atma is enjoying sleep. The bliss is there. In deep sleep. So, and that is called Atma. That Atma is Brahman. That self is Brahman. In your deep, see, when Upanishad rishis teach you, Atma is Brahman. You don't understand what is Atma. I don't understand what is Atma. Where is that Atma? How do I experience it? You'll ask. You cannot tell something which you don't understand. So your inner self in deep sleep is called Pratyaga Atma, innermost self, because it is the innermost chamber. Understand? In the innermost station chamber, you are Atma only. But there is no self-knowledge. I am Brahman knowledge is not there. Because ignorance comes in the waking state. That ignorance has to go. So you are sleeping. You are enjoying the bliss because it's non-dual. But you don't know yourself. So both are there. Ignorance is there and bliss is there. Clear? But because of your karma, your pending actions are there. Actions are pending. So the prana will open the door. And you don't have to ask. It will just open. In the morning, you have to get up and start doing all your work. The birds have to get up and start flying. It opens automatically. The door will be open. That prana opens the door. Then the radiation from the self, Atma Jyoti, will come. The light of the self. It falls on the Mahatattva, and then it falls on number 5 called mirror. Mirror. Mirror is the ego. Right? So here the ego or the mind is aham, I am. Okay? So morning, you get up in the morning, there is a feeling, the world has not come, body has not come, they say, I am. That I am is, I am which is not associated with anybody, just pure I am, is Ishvara, the universal consciousness. It's there for everybody. Pure, until it gets associated with everybody, one body. Correct? That is coming from the sattva guna, sattva aspect. Now, rajas and tamas is there for individual jiva. That rajas and tamas project the body. Body and vasanas will rise. Then it goes to number 6. Number 6 where? It is six. This is the window. The sense gates, karmendriya and jnanendriya, they become functional. First is jnanendriya, sense organs. Body becomes active, and through windows, they are windows to the world. The light of the self, Atma Jyoti, goes out. The radiation goes out through the window called eyes or sense organs. Then the 7 is nothing but 7 is actually deep sleep. 7 is nothing but sleep. You are in the sleep state. In the sleep state, you are enjoying the bliss. Atma is enjoying the bliss. But it doesn't know itself. It is ignorant of the self. Even
Guruji, sleep is dream state and 7 deep sleep. It's a deep sleep state. And the second one is prana.
No, second one is the door of sleep. The sleep of starting of the sleep, ending of the sleep. Okay. So in the Atma is in deep sleep state. Deep sleep state, it enjoys the bliss. But it does not know itself. Okay? It is pending. Actions are pending. Tomorrow what I have to do? Okay? It doesn't know I am Brahman. It's enjoying the deep sleep state. Blissful state, which is non-dual. It's own nature. It's Swarupa, Swarupa, Ananda, it's experiencing. But it doesn't know Swarupa, Jnana. I am Brahman, it doesn't know. Right? Okay, because it doesn't know I am Brahman, it has to. If I am Brahman, I am the boss. No, I don't have to do anything. I am blissful. I don't want to come out of the room itself. Now, it has to come out. It doesn't physically come out, it radiation will come out. Light will come out. Light of the Jyoti, right? Atma Jyoti will come out. Okay, it will come out and it will come out through the windows of sense organs. Right? And it will fall in the courtyard, which is the outside of the house. Courtyard is the physical world, which is called waking state. So there you feel the gross body and the physical world. There's number 9. Okay. So you already built the house. Okay. So I remember the words of Buddha when he got enlightened. Okay. The Buddha, when he got enlightened, he said, for many lifetimes I suffered. I didn't know who is the builder of this mansion, the house. Who built this house? Now I have found the builder of the house. I have dismantled the house. No longer shall I build the house. He also used the house example. Buddha also. What is this house? The body mind complex. Okay. Ramana Maharshi also gives the example of house, body mind complex. So you live in the, Atma lives in the house in the ignorance, thinking that I am in the body. Identifies with its image, ego. Okay? You see your reflection in the mirror, ego. So there is a reflection. When the door of sleep opens, there's a mirror here. Number five is mirror, which is the ego. Ego reflects the mind. So ego reflects and says, I am the body. The Atma takes itself to be the body. Okay? You remember the story of Narcissus, which I tell? Right? The Narcissus is the king. Okay? He keeps on looking at his image in the pond and thinks that he is the image. And he is fasting and he dies also. That's called Narcissism. So the Atma falls, Atma identifies itself with the image. Right? So it's in the image, which is a reflected image in the ego. Ego is called aham. Okay? The aham associates the body. To associate the body, light has to go out further through sense organs. Then it becomes ahamkara. Aham takes the akara. Akara of the body. Then it becomes a doer. Right? At the level of the ego, there is aham. Aham means I am. The self is waking up and saying, I exist. It feels I exist. The moment I exist, it sees the body and says, I have the body. Okay. So when it'll go out to the courtyard. It'll go to the courtyard and enjoy all the things. And it'll all karma phala, all these things it'll enjoy. It'll experience all the karma. And goes back. And then door closes. It goes to the bedroom and the door closes. The prana closes the door. You fall asleep. And it enjoys the bliss. It enjoys the bliss. Because it's nature and bliss. Atma only. But it doesn't know I am the Atma. I am Brahman.
Okay. Prana does the closing and opening. What is the role of
Mahatattva? Mahatattva is the complete blueprint of the whole universe. No? Universe has to be projected now. Ishvara. Universe. See, your individual asanas, you have. Your individual asana and the universe, everything blueprint is there in Mahatattva, the film.
Something like
film. The film is there. Film is the Mahatattva, Ishvara. Then the film, the images are there, which is you, Jiva, your asanas. Both the Ishvara. The sky is to be there, sky is required, the earth is required, the plants are required. That is not your individual vasana, that's a universal, that's the film.
What is common to all?
What is common to all? That's Mahatattva. In that, you also have an image, your vasana, Jiva. So, this entire thing has to be projected on the outside. If you, without Ishvara, you can't see the sky, you can't see the objective reality. The objective reality and subjective reality will get mixed up. First objective reality, first film comes, then the image comes on that. Then gets projected. It's clear? Ramana Maharshi is making it so clear. Okay? And also he tells immediately, please understand, all these are imagined. Nothing is happening really. And Atma, these are all imagined. Atma. Nothing is happening. It's a dream. Okay? Now, how does the realization happen? So this guy goes out and enjoys. But see, Atma doesn't go out anywhere. Okay? It, because the light of the self, Atma Jyoti, falls on the body and the mind and senses, it becomes alive. It disappears to be the outer wall, no? That what is that? The external this thing, chamber appears to be alive, gross body. And it starts experiencing, thinking that I am the body, I am the mind, I am the intellect. Okay, and it accumulates all the karma, impressions. Again, when the gatekeeper comes and closes the door, you are tired now. Today is enough. Tomorrow you go. The servant will close the door. You go to arrest. Okay. Next day morning, servant will faithfully open the door. Okay, now go and go work.
Go enjoy.
Go enjoy. Servant will do the work faithfully. Okay. You can please understand. If the karma is over, you will never come out of the sleep. Okay, and the servant will take you from one body, one karma is over, then the servant will take you to another body also. So the pending work. So he's the servant. No, he'll take, master, come to another body. He'll take another body also. Right?
Who is servant, Guruji, here?
What's that?
Who is servant here? Mind?
No, no, prana, prana, prana. So I told earlier that prana, number two, is the door of sleep, no?
Okay.
Door of sleep is here, right?
Yeah, yeah.
The sleep door is opened and closed by the prana.
Prana.
When the sleep door is closed, the mind is not there. Mind is number five. So in yes, the deep sleep, mind is absent. Okay. Chitabhasa is absent. Reflection is not there.
Okay. Got it.
Right? So this is how Ramana Maharshi says the three bodies come into picture. Because this guy keeps on building the bodies. The servant, the prana shakti will keep on building. One body or one body becomes old, it says another body will build. The servant will build another body with the mind. Okay. Now, how does the reaction happen? So this Atma is identifying with the Atma is identifying with the number five, the mirror, the reflection, which is the in the form of Chidabhasa. What is identifying Chidabhasa is nothing but reflection of self only. Atma Jyoti only falling on that is the reflection, which is nothing but Atma only. So this guy, Jiva, the number five is mirror, which is the mind, ego, aham, with the Chidabhasa, reflected consciousness. So he will ask, who am I? Okay. The teaching is given, Tattvamasi, you are that. You are Brahman. Okay. So then what is that you are that? You have to understand, I am not the body, not the mind, not the intellect. I am the witness, which is the Atma. Okay. You have to understand, reflection in the mirror is not me. I am the original face. You have to remember your original face. Okay. So the original face is Atma and Atma is Brahman. Brahman is awareness. So now when you go, your attention goes back to the Atma, then there is no world because world disappears. The world is Mithya, unreal. So Atma alone is there and Atma is Brahman. That's called Brahma Satya, Jagan Mithya. So, is the explanation given clear? Any questions?
Hari Om Prabhuji.
Hari Om Madhavanji.
The mirror is facing towards the inner chamber, towards the causal body.
No, the mirror is like, you can say the mirror is not, don't take the mirror analogy very like that. It's a, it's a only analogy.
Okay.
Right? It's a, it's like it becomes, you can think it's like a more, like when you take a magnet, iron piece will become magnetized.
Okay.
Okay. It's an induction happens.
Okay.
The mirror is told only for the common man's language.
Okay.
It's a phenomenon of induction.
Okay.
Right. Earlier, yesterday, I gave an example of an iron ball.
Yes.
Iron ball, here is the iron ball is equivalent to mirror. The iron ball gets heated up.
Mm-hmm.
Right, so like that, it's not facing the inner chamber, it's that it just gets induced consciousness gets.
Okay.
The ego is inert.
Yes.
Right.
Thank you, Prabhuji.
And that inert ego has a feeling of I am. That is okay. A thought feeling.
Okay.
That feeling becomes alive. I am. Then that means there's Atma, this self recognize. Oh, I exist.
Mm-hmm.
Right. I am is I exist.
Hmm.
So far, it's not aware of its existence.
Yes.
Right? The moment you wake up from sleep, it becomes I exist.
Hmm.
Okay. In that I exist, there's no other.
Okay.
And that is called the universal self or Ishwara.
Hmm.
That's where I am comes into picture. There's no association now.
Hmm.
Okay. Then all the forms and names appear because of the vasanas, impressions.
Hmm.
Then it associates one body and says, I am this body. Then they become Jiva.
Hmm.
The Aham is the Ishwara. Hmm. Ahamkara is the Jiva.
Hmm.
Aham gets associated with the Akara, form.
Hmm.
Right?
Yes.
When you say Tattvamasi, you contemplate Aham Brahmasmi. Okay?
Okay.
Aham Brahmasmi is in ego, Ahamkara is there. Aham Akara is there.
Hmm.
Right? What is Aham Akara? The body, mind, and intellect is the akara, form.
Mm.
I am this form.
Mm.
That form you remove.
Mm.
from ahankara form you remove. Okay, then what it means is aham. That aham is I am, I exist. Who exists? I, the pure I, which is atma. So the I in the I am points to atma, the self. I am is the feeling of existence because there's a reflection has happened. Okay, so like that, aham brahmasmi means I am. Okay, where I is pointed to consciousness, am is pointed to existence. That by mistake that I am gets associated to the manifest outer. It is called what you call as a dehatma buddhi. Then it becomes ahamkara. Ahamkara is the ego. Whereas aham is many people say it's ego eating. Just to distinguish between ego and ego eating. Right? In Sanskrit, it's easier to say aham and ahamkara. So the aham is Brahman. One who says aham is Brahman. Okay. Before that reflection took place, the Atma, the self, was not aware of its own nature as Brahman, all pervading reality. With the Atma Vichara and Atma Jnana, it recognizes its true nature. Then it will decide to take a retirement. Then it will not do any further work. Then the prana will not open the gates of sleep. Then the whole world, whole walls and doors, they disappear because there's no awareness, the light only. I am the self, I am Brahman, all pervading reality. There's none other than me. Any questions now?
Thank you.
So this is actually, I can see the relationship between what Ramana Maharshi says and the Buddha's explanation after enlightenment. He speaks of, he built a mansion. He doesn't know who built the mansion. Then he destroyed the mansion. And then he says it's because of craving. Buddha speaks about craving. Ramana Maharshi speaks of ignorance, ajnana. Okay. Anybody else have any question? If there are no questions, let us sit silently for some time. Take your attention back to ourself, the Atma. By shifting by inquiring, who am I inquiry has three steps: self-inquiry, self-abidance, and self-knowledge. Self-inquiry is who am I? So in that who am I, I'll eliminate all the observed. Drashyam I'll see, drop, and I'll go to Drak, which is the self, Atma. I recognize myself and everything, the ego I recognize as my reflection. I am the self. So that self is Brahman, awareness. When I stay in that, that's called self-abidance. Then there's an understanding in the intellect that I am Brahman. That's called self-knowledge. Aham Brahmasmi. In that self-knowledge, aham is Brahman. And that aham brahmasmi means that aham or I is not the body, mind or intellect. The awareness is Brahman. The sakshi is Brahman. Okay. So let us look. In that picture I gave earlier, so the awareness, light of the self spreads from the atma to the outer room. When it spreads to the outer room, it's called consciousness or chidabhasa. The body, mind, and world is in chidabhasa. Typically, the English word is consciousness. And the nature of self is awareness, the knowing principle. So let us close our eyes and take our attention to the self. Thank you. सतोमा सद्गमया तमसोमा ज्योतिर्गमया मृत्योर्मा अमृतं गमया ओम शांति 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 ही पूर्णमदः पूर्णमिदं पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदुच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते ओम शांति शांति शांतिः लोकाः समस्ताः सुखिनो भवन्तु लोकाः समस्ताः सुखिनो भवन्तु। लोकाः समस्ताः सुखिनो भवन्तु नान नानेम्बुदु नानल्ल इदेह मन बुद्धि नानल्ल सचिदानंदात्म शिवनानुनाने शिवोहम 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 I am not the body, mind or intellect. I am pure consciousness, Shivaswarupi. Atmadarshanam, Brahmadarshanam, Brahmadarshanam, Satyadarshanam. Just rub your both hands, both palms you rub and give warmth to the eyes. Slowly open your eyes. Any questions on YouTube? Nobody is there. Okay.
Swamiji, I want to thank you. Okay. You explained ahamkara and ahankara, the difference between the two. I'm so happy to hear that.
Aham is universal.
Universal.
Aham.
Okay. Yeah.
Aham is universal. That's Ishvara.
Ishvara. Yes.
When that takes a form called ahamkara, aham takes a akara.
Akara.
Then it becomes individual.
Yes.
Right?
Thank you for explaining.
Both Ishvara and Jiva are together there.
Yes. Okay.
Okay. Very good.
Thank you. Thank you.
Welcome. Anybody else has any questions?
Namaskara Gurukule. Nangu ashte aham matte ahankara madhya vyatyasa helikottiddu tumba simple agitto manasakke takshana hogta ide.
Okay. Very
Namaskara.
Good. Okay. Namaste. Okay. Shall we close for the day? So, we'll close for the day. Tomorrow we'll take up next topic. Namaste. Hari Om.